there's something you would like that you don't see, I'll get it for you. No salt or pepper.
No, this is fine. What was your favorite meat product when you were?
Hamburger.
Hamburger? You ate a lot of hamburgers?
Yep. The best meal in the world was pork and beans, potato salad, and hamburger. I could eat that 3 times a day, every day. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Didn't make any difference.
Really?
Loved it. Turned out okay.
Mm. Why so, not say it turned out great?
Well, if my wife cooked, it would have been better.
Mm.
But it just goes to show that if an old cattle farmer can do this, anybody can do it. It's just a matter of time.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't mean that we should slack off on what we're doing. But if we do everything we have the capability of doing, we will win. There's no doubt in my mind.
The FAO has made some very interesting calculations. Between 1950 and the year 2000, the world population grew from 2.6 billion to 6 billion people. Yet meat production increased fivefold, from 45 to 233 billion kilos of meat each year. It's predicted that there will be 9 billion people living on our planet by the year 2050. And what will happen with the meat production? The meat production will double to 450 billion kilos of meat by the year 2050. And of course, the greenhouse gas emissions will double too. And I'm talking about kilos of meat every time, but of course we are talking about living and breathing animals.
In a lifetime, the average European will eat 7 sheep, 24 rabbits, 43 turkeys, 789 fish, a third of a horse, 5 cows, 42 pigs, and 900 chickens.
So the average European devours 1,800 animals in a lifetime. If every person on our planet were to do the same, we would need 142 billion animals every year. In truth, the agricultural sector worldwide has gone off the rails. The cycle has become completely disrupted because we have started to produce meat as cheaply and intensively as possible. Forests in South America are disappearing because Europe demands huge amounts of animal feed. The gigantic factory farming industry in the United States, the huge level of meat consumption in the Western world, all at the expense of the climate, biodiversity, drinking water, and food for the very poorest people on Earth. If we don't change our eating habits, we will be consuming 450 billion kilos of meat by 2050. What does that mean for our planet? Dr. Steinfeld, what does that mean for our planet? What's your scenario?
Well, there is a pessimistic scenario, and that is that nothing is done about it and we continue to produce animals in the way we do right now. And in that case, the environmental impact is going to deteriorate beyond measure. And there is a need to urgently address this issue and to deal with waste, to deal with greenhouse gas emissions, to deal with biodiversity losses. And measures are available, technology options are available. What is lacking is the political willingness to act on these and to steer the livestock sector into a more sustainable way.
But suppose we eat no meat for, let's say, one day a week. Will that have any positive impact on the environment? What do you think?
Well, the impact of livestock production is probably disproportionately high compared to other sectors. So reducing consumption is likely to have a positive impact on the environment.
What do you expect? Are we going to eat less meat in the future?
I think that the human health concerns and the welfare, animal welfare concerns and the environmental concerns will be increasingly appreciated by a growing number in the public, and that will lead to a slow decline in, at least that's my personal prediction, to a slow decline in the consumption of meat in particular.
Okay, thank you. Dr. Steinfeld is not very optimistic, but he also points to a lack of real political will to change things. Yet, is this enough to lead us to despair? Well, I don't think so. There are some rays of hope, tiny rays of hope. I think that is just because people simply don't know. I'm sure that if they knew, they'd want to change their eating habits. But even politicians, who you would expect to know more, haven't got the faintest clue. This became crystal clear during a recent debate on deforestation in the Dutch parliament.
De ontbossing, meneer Blom, zoals u weet, wordt voor een heel groot deel ook veroorzaakt door onze intensieve veehouderij.
Ja, ik vind het altijd verbazingwekkend hoe de Partij van de Dieren in staat is om een onderwerp per interruptie te introduceren wat absoluut niet gaat over de tekst die ik hiervoor uitsprak. U moet mij niet kwalijk nemen dat ik geen idee heb wat de relatie is tussen intensieve veehouderij en de relatie tot ontbossing. Ik weet niet waar. Het spijt me, maar dan moet ik u helaas
dat zie
het
u
antwoord
niet.
Op schuldig blijven. Nee, dat zie ik me waarschijnlijk niet, maar ik weet het gewoon niet.
But in fact, it's all so simple. Less meat, fewer animals, reduced greenhouse gas emissions, reduced water use and less deforestation. Johan Rank has directed music videos for Madonna, Beyoncé and Robbie Williams. And when he heard about the environmental problems caused by livestock farming, he thought, shit, man, and made a very simple yet very effective short film that I don't want to keep from you.